Hi everyone, I'm Michael. Today I would like to talk about magic and use of magic system within the Foundry virtual tabletop with the Witcher system. To be able to demonstrate that, I'm using the Foundry in a way that since it is easier for me to demonstrate. However, that the principle are the same if you're playing face to face or any other form of medium. So the magic in the Witcher RPG is different to D&D in a way that, since I'm using that as an example, since that's where I was playing and I'm still playing and where I'm coming from, they're only priests, druids, witcher, and mages are only the four class who can use magic, and then they have different aspects. So mages can learn spell through the conventional learning at the magical schools. Druids and preachers or priests get from their divine or their source of power, and witchers could only use signs. In terms of casting spell, in fact, this is a lot more straightforward. We need to know two areas. I will just show you what I mean by that. So I'm gonna open my mage character here. So to be able to cast a spell, things are important are will and spell casting. So these are the two criteria we use, stat and skill. And then we need to know stamina. So stamina determine how many spell you can cast. So Aislinn has 35 stamina, so he can cast until his spent stamina ran out. However, how many spell he can cast in a round? Well, he can cast any number of spells he likes, provided that he is up to it. So in Witcher, the bottleneck is this Vigor. So Vigor determines that how many stamina he can cast before having problems or issues. So here, have a look. I have five different spell. So if he casts, let's say, Earthen Spike, and I'm gonna use just normal spell. So you can see that there is will and spell casting modifier and d10 plus. That's what we need to roll, 24. So the defender or the enemies can either use dodge or block action. Duration is immediate, range is 6 meter. And then because it is damage, I added damage roll. That's the amount of damage. Now, Aislinn, if decided that, want to cast further. So he already used 5 stamina, which is his Vigor cap here. So if he use any more, he is going to spend 5 hit points per 1 point of stamina he costs. So let's say he want to cast Dormin's Fork. And then this require 3 stamina. So stamina was automatically subtracted. However, there is no automatic reduction of HP. So in this instance, Aislinn should lose 15 hit points just from casting this spell. So you can literally cast 10 spells if you have stamina and hit points to spare. So it is something to consider as a strategy. Of course, when we are adding the spell to the character, the best way to do that is by adding the spell here first. So here I have three different folders: Invocation, Mage Spell, and Witcher Sign. So if I look at Mage Spell, let's say Earthen Spike. So there are a few things we need to do. So if I want to add a new spell, let's say add new. So in the book that will falls under the mage spell, let's go add something easy. Telepathy. So that is in the mix. So if I want to add a new, I'm just gonna do this telepathy spell add. So it is spell, novice level, this is mix element. So there is some issue, so I changed that and then it automatically put novice and mix. Stamina course is 2 to cast that, and range is 10 meter, and duration is active. Now it says 1 STA, so it requires 1 stamina to maintain that. Defense is none, so it can't be defended. So I copy the text, enter that. So there are two fields down here. So if I add a template here, if I click it, that will allow me to create a grid size a template on the map. So it will create whenever I am casting that. And if I can also add damage, and this is the damage roll. But the telepathy is not a damage spell, so I turn that off. And let's go with some nice icon. So that will be mine. So what do we use? Air control, defensive. That's the control. All right, let's use this funny eye thing. So at least I added one spell, and after doing that, all I have to do is drag this and put in the character sheet there. So I can add that way, and I can add that to the telepathy. So 25. So in this instance, the number here doesn't really matter. So this is only as long as it is not fumble. So in terms of adding there in the current Foundry system, you can add different type of spell. So if I go back, a new spell. So let's say, spell. So if you look at the drop down, you can add invocation, ritual, and hex. So if you put hex, this is effects, requirement, live, stamina course, and danger. If you are looking ritual, they are different fields. Again, effects and component. They are free text field, you can't drag and drop. Witcher signs are similar. I already created Witcher signs here for some art. So this is what I created. And then here you can see there is a 10%. So this is a variable stamina cost. So you can add that Witcher sign, invocation. Invocation, you can add druid, preacher, or archpriest, different on the level, and you can add spell. So spell, even though it's a common name, we don't call druid spell or priest spell. So spell only belongs to mage, only mage and can learn that. So here, in terms of invocation, I added 2. So this is Web of Lies. Duration is that the defendant has to roll intelligence to succeed it. All right, let's do a bit of an example. I'm just gonna reset the numbers. So here, so if I click this, receive new hand, whatever it is, everything is here. Don't know why this doesn't reset. Alright, so our bot has a fight with the priest, sorry, the mage. Oh, the background is from James RPG Art, by the way. It is very cool. Alright, we will roll initiative. So there is a fight between arguments broke out. And we roll initiative. And we begin combat. So the mage is the one starting. So on its turn. Why is it not okay? So decided that it's going to cast Earthen Spike on. So if you want to know what it is, if you click this, it will shows. So the this is the more of the heat. FNs is more of the illusion. Alright, let's say we will cast Earthen Spike. That's where our bard is standing. So that it rolled 20. So that's it, the mage turn. And during that turn, Andras can decide to dodge or defend, depending on how it goes. So let's say defend. So it's a dodge or block, so it's gonna dodge that. And only 12, so our bard failed to dodge the magic spell, so Aislinn can this time click damage. Wow. So it is the 25. So what do we do? I select this and I click apply damage. Now the damage happens to the arm, so change location arm, and you can see that Aislinn has some armor wearing at the arms. So let's see. So the because of the modification, its total was 25, because of the stopping power of the armor. Because there is nothing wearing on the arm, there is no reduction, and because of the hitting on the arm, it's only half of it, so 12.5. So 12 damage apply here, based on the initial XP. And in terms of at the start of, okay, the Andras might do something else or run around to maintain that. So in the say spells which are active require maintaining every round, the mage must spend the amount of STA equal to the value next to active. So while it is similar to concentration in D&D, while the mage is maintaining that, he cannot cast any other spell. So if he casts any other spell, the spike will disappear. So I would imagine there are spikes coming up on the ground surrounding Andras, and the mage is holding that, and every round the mage has to spend. How much was it? It doesn't say. All right, let me have a look. Well, there is no maintenance Earthen Spike, so that's easy. I thought there was maintenance cost. No, it wasn't. So that's a single d damage. So if there is any spell that requires stamina to maintain that, and then that would require us to spend that point. So in short combat, that's not a big issue, but if you use a lot of stamina for other reason, and then that could be a problem. So if your mage has to learn, want to learn a new spell, there is a table in the book that explain how you can spend the magic. So, oh, before I go there, players can acquire focus items. So that could be a staff or any other magical items that reduce the Vigor threshold. Sorry, that add Vigor threshold, in a way, reduce the requirement. So if you add that, the Vigor threshold will increase gradually. However, it requires magical focuses. There are others like rituals and hexes you can add. So it is something that they need to learn. So in the learning magic, so this is what, page 123 on the book. So Novice spell can take 10 IP improvement points. So you need to accumulate 10 points, and then they can learn by themselves, or they can learn from someone who can teach them. So that could be another mage, priest, or a magical tome. Or so that depends on yourself as a keeper, whether you want to provide magical books as a loot. And there is time. So for example, 4 days are needed to learn Novice level spell, and learning DC is 14, and 2 learning checks need to be done. So unlike D&D, where if you level up you get spells automatically, it doesn't happen here. Mages are super powerful, but at the same time it comes with a lot of restriction along the way. On top of that, if you are keen, you can learn from different Archmage, scientists, or politician level skill trees as well. So that's option to consider. In terms of other spell point of view, I find that the spells invocation, it makes the process easier, but things like rituals and hexes, they are mainly text in the book, so using a virtual tabletop doesn't necessarily improve the workflow. So I don't usually enter them. I usually only mention them if there is any story element to it. In terms of the other cool thing about magic is Fumble Table. So if the mage casts a spell, and that is in the combat chapter, magic resolutions. So magical targeting. So if the magic fumble, it's depending on the total number. If your fumble is more than 9, that's the catastrophic effect. Let's test that out. I might need to roll a few rounds. 7, 1. All right. So Aislinn fumbled the telepathy. So even though it is 17, it's still a fumble. So you roll that. So it's only a total 8. So when you fumble, you look at the table, and the you look at it. It also depends on the fumble type. So the fumble is eight. So in the 7 to 9, the magic that is already partially through you ignite inside you. Not only does the spell fail, but you suffer an elemental fumble effect, as noted below. So because it is 8, so 1 to 6 is that you lost 1 point, so that's okay. The spell doesn't happen. 7 to 9, your spell fail and fumble effect happen. So this is a mixed element. So the effects is magic sparks out of your body. You not only take 1 point of damage. So because of the Aislinn spent 2 stamina, that's sorry, not 2 stamina. So it is fumbled by 8. So the 8 points of damage. One of the effects below, chosen randomly. So earth, air, fire, water. So because mixed element require everything, if fumble, a lot of things can happen. So I would say it start from earth, air, fire, water. So I would say roll d4. Well, water. So Aislinn will notice frost crackles and harden around his body, and he takes additional 1 point of damage for every point he fumble, and by also frozen. So the way I rule it, that is, he will get one. I would only rule one if one type of damage. So if I read according to the book, you will take 1 point of damage per your roll, as well as if you go into water, you will also have another point of damage. So in theory, Aislinn should lose 16 hit points just by fumbling this. So it's very scary in that regard. And it also want to emphasize the chaotic nature of the magic. It's all good and well if things are going nice, but if it fumble, it is quite bad. All right, I hope this is as clear as mud. Yeah, I hope you find this video useful, and if you like this or find that helpful, please click like and subscribe, and that will be very useful. Thank you. Have a good day.